Oh's working. Doodle doodle doodly do doodle
loop. Doodle loop. Oop, I am loud.
So we are gonna do a thing. It's gonna be called the Jurymore Podcast. And what's with the hat? What's with that silly ass
hat? That was me. That was me. Me.
I just gotten out of the shower before jury, so I just put it on and then I just kept it on. I mean, that's like,
can I see what it looks like without it? Looks great. I dig it. It's a good look. Not. It's a good look for you.
I prefer no. All right. Hey. Okay. Let's, yeah. Thanks, man. Good looking, fam. That's what I'm talking about. Gatorwag action. All right. So you ready to record?
Let's just hit the record and roll with it.
Okay.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Jurymore, our brand spanking new. Right, hold on, Is it not working?
It's not working.
Oh. I think I'm a little blown out.
You are.
Check, 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 check. Check, 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 check.
Check, check, check. Oh, come on, man. I'm about to turn off, but. Turn on the butt.
Butt.
Double complete rainbow. Oh, man. We haven't done that in forever. Okay. They look like shit here. Fucking hate these cards. I don't have enough time to do things. I just hate that we only have the one fucking shot and it looks like shit. And I don't have time to. No, that's not what I want.
I'll try and play with it while you're gone. On the screen.
It's on the what?
It's squeezing the screen.
Oh, it's on the.
There you go.
All right. Here we go.
Check.
We just stopped doing the intro for Night Attack. Yeah. All right. Here we go. 3, 2, 1.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the brand spanking new Jurymore podcast. I'm Ashley Paramore.
And I'm Justin Robert Young, otherwise known as Jury to people.
On them, their internets.
Well, I mean, that might be something that a lot of people don't know, because a lot of people that are be listening to this are like family and stuff, right?
Probably. Hi, Mom.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi, Mom. Both are our moms.
Moms, plural.
Yeah.
So we are doing this brand spanking new podcast because I don't know if you guys have heard, but we're getting married.
We are. It's finally happening. We've been dating for over 27 years.
I mean, that we got together when I was one.
We met at the bottom of the ocean at a convention for pearls.
I don't think that's right.
I think this is right. I was a widower who had just turned 64.
Okay.
And you were 1 year old.
How old are you now?
The youngest pearl diver in the history of the ocean.
I don't think you're recalling this correctly.
It was love at first sight over two basil gimlets.
I mean, the basil gimlet part I think is right, but the rest I'm not sure of.
And nor should you be, by the way, because these are all lies, which is what we like to do on this show, is lie to each other.
Much like you lied to me not too long ago, I did. Actually.
I did. I lied to you. I'm sick of all this truth we have. We have a very well-functioning relationship. We get along a lot, you know, and in general, it's a healthy communication back and forth. And yet I had to deviate from that to get engaged to you.
Yeah.
Because we were too healthy. We needed to inject a good dollop of lies.
Well, so let's get real here.
Let's get really real,
let's
son.
Let's get really real. First, I want to mention that this podcast is going to wind up being a lot of us talking about us and our relationships, and probably relationships a little bit in general, through our adventure of wedding planning. So sorry to subject you guys to some of that. So that'll be fun. Just things that are going on in our lives.
So
like,
where do you
want to
start
lies.
Out? I mean, like, all right, so number one, this is kind of to give everybody the roadmap of the podcast. This is going to be leading up to our marriage. Our marriage is going to happen Labor Day 2015.
Labor Day weekend, not technically Labor Day.
Labor Day weekend in Atlanta, Georgia, at Dragon Con. If you're listening to this, you're invited. Everyone's invited. It's going to be a public event, part of Dragon Con programming. So, you know, you might have to get your ass down there if you want to hang out with us. It's going to be a fun time.
You'll need a ticket for entry, but yeah. it'll be fun. Be a whole bunch of fun.
So that's number one. Number two, this podcast will chronicle us getting to that point and going through all the steps that it takes for that. And so if that sounds boring and dumb, then seriously stop listening, because I'm tired of your shit.
Yep. Get out.
Get it.
Out.
Get it out.
Out.
And so here's why. You know, look, Carl asks Jerry and Ashley, how much of your families are going to be scared and confused by DragonCon? These are good topics we'll be discussing on the show. You know, there's a lot of just things that we need to book and people we need to talk to and things we need to set up and fun surprises.
And we're going like way the non-traditional route, which we'll probably have a giant conversation about at, you know, a future episode.
Yeah, we can't give everything
future episode.
Away
we can't.
On the first date. Let's talk about me lying to you.
Because you're a terrible liar.
I feel like I've told this story on different shows 3 times, but I want you to tell your version of the story, and I'll just pepper in where I lied to you.
All right. I'm going to start prior to engagement.
Yeah.
Maybe about a year-ish ago.
Okay.
We're both at the point of our lives where all of our friends around us are getting married.
Uh-huh.
And so we would go to our friends' weddings and say, like, oh, I like this, I hated this, blah, blah, blah. Yeah. And naturally, you just go into a conversation about Unity Sand and how fucking stupid it is and how...
I feel like we
How
shouldn't
shit on
Unity Sand that hard, because Carolyn might listen to this.
Oh, it's not for us, though. It's not. Totally not for
it
us.
It was for them.
It was for them. We are
they
shitting
love
on it pretty
sand.
Hard. They love sand. It is, it is kind of cute, to be fair, but it's not us. It's not an us thing.
No.
Which will be another conversation for later.
Yeah.
But
we're weird.
We are very weird people. So we have had conversations at our friends' weddings and had, because considering I moved across the country to live with this bearded man.
Yes.
It seemed like a very realistic conversation to have. Are we going to get
married?
So
for people who are just listening to it now, like, we had dated long distance for a while. I moved out to Oakland and I was here for what, 4 months, 5 months? And then I coaxed you into moving out?
Yeah. And I moved out like 6 months later or something. You were about out here about a year before I moved out.
No, less than that.
Okay.
Yeah. But it was around there. Like, and so there were a lot of elements that were kind of leading up to it. Like, we were at a point where it was like, we had stepped very gradually into the point of like, we should probably talk about marriage, because there was a lot of these escalation points, like, you know, like, we're dating long distance and now we're living together and now, like, and it was over a period of years. It just made a lot of sense.
Well, and so we were having these conversations about marriage, and mm-hmm. one of the things I mentioned was like, look, bro, no hurry to get married, but if we're gonna get married, I need a year to plan. Weddings take time and a lot of money. You know, we got to get ahead of the game. We got to be able to plan out and everything. And we had kind of roughly discussed, because we both already knew that we wanted to get married in Atlanta at Dragon Con, if possible, because it's between our families. It's where we met, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah. There's a lot of good reasons.
And I told you, just give me a year, whenever. We had tentatively kind of in our heads thought about 2015.
Well, I think that it was just, it made sense, right? Like, it was just that we were getting to that point. We were getting to, like, the point where you cross a certain point, and in general, as a rule of thumb, every relationship's different, it's about at the three-year mark. The three-year mark, it starts to become not a should we, but will we kind of conversation.
Will we and when?
Yes. And will we is the close border pal to when. And when is the close border pal to seriously when. And seriously when is the close border pal to I'm going to leave you if this doesn't happen.
I don't think I've ever been that crazy.
You have not. No. You have not. Many people are.
What did happen, though, is because we had had these loose conversations about, you know, when it would be, where it would be, ideas of what we wanted to do for our wedding.
Yeah.
And then, since we had kind of tentatively talked about 2015, went to Dragon Con this year. Like, wow, Justin's mom's coming to Dragon Con? Whoa. Man, it'd be really something if he actually, oh, wow, maybe we are on target for 2015. Maybe he's going to propose to me at Dragon Con.
Wait, you thought I was going to propose at Dragon Con?
I did. I thought you were going to do it, and then you didn't. I'm like, oh, well, maybe he doesn't want to do 2015. So about maybe a week passes after Dragon Con, and that's when I talked to you. I'm like, hey, so, you know, that whole marriage thing in 2015 at Dragon Con, we still do it? We still on track? We still want to do that? And you're like, oh, yeah, totally. And...
Well, all right, so let's go back. Let's go back, because when you're like, I need a year to plan.
Yes.
I was kind of like, I mean, a year, right? Like, come on.
Most
come on.
People spend more than a year planning their wedding.
Not really. Not everybody.
You don't...
You know,
this is why people wind up hiring wedding planners.
Should have a year. Should have a year. I mean, I'm just saying. Like, it's just like I didn't take you seriously.
I obviously.
Also, I didn't have any plan on proposing to you at Dragon Con. I was so overwhelmed with so much other stuff.
I obviously figured that part out. But because I thought that you might have proposed at Dragon Con.
Yeah.
And we had talked about getting married in 2015 at Dragon Con. I was like, well, shit, I've got, if we're going to do somewhat of a traditional thing, I've got to get rolling on this now. And so I told you, it's like, well, if this is still in the cards, I'm going to start looking at venues. I'm going to start blah, 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 blah.
Yeah.
And I have been planning the wedding for 2 months prior to getting engaged.
Yeah. Which I'm glad you feel comfortable enough to talk about publicly, because you were very weird about me telling people that you had been planning the wedding.
Okay. To be fair, you were making a joke out of me looking crazy.
I was not making a joke out of you looking crazy. It was my answer to when people said, when I showed them the ring, which is where we're going to get to, and they'd be like, oh my God, that's so great. Does she know? Does she know that she's getting proposed to? My response would be, oh, are you kidding? She's been planning the wedding for 2 months.
That just makes me sound like a crazier person than I am.
It's also a legitimate, indisputable fact.
It is. But when you say it that way, you make me sound like a crazy person.
Well, I mean, listen, maybe it's not in how I'm saying it. Maybe you are exhibiting objectively crazy behavior. Anyhow, so you don't. So you've been planning the wedding. We both know that an engagement is coming.
Yes.
You start really tweaking about when this engagement's coming.
Well, because there was really not a lot of anything that looks like was moving in the direction of you actually proposing.
Yeah.
And for me, I could give two shits about a formal proposal.
Yeah.
Or if you proposed to me with fucking bubblegum and a ring pop, like, I would have been thrilled with it. For me, knowing that we were going to do it at Dragon Con, and knowing how crazy that hotel situation is and being unable to like block hotel rooms for family members that are commuting for it and like all the crazy housing dilemma, like I wanted to get rolling, like, you know, as soon as possible to let people know, family particularly, that we were getting married and they needed to book hotels now. And all of that was contingent on when you were going to get me the ring.
Well,
because that was the okay threshold to talk to family about it. Because nothing makes you look crazier when talking to your boss and other people about this wedding you're planning when you don't have a ring on your finger.
Is that weird? Is that not cool?
Oh my God.
Is that not a cool thing to have happen?
My boss was just like, so are you guys engaged yet? I'm like, well, not technically, but it's going to happen. Like, it's going to be here next year.
So you were looking like a crazy person.
Oh my God, yes.
So you started really getting on me about the ring. You were like,
yeah.
So, ring shopping.
I was sending
you. How's the ring shopping going? It was like, it got to a point where it was every conversation. You'd be like, hey, can you get almond milk? And we need, make sure you feed the birds.
And put it in the wonder list.
Yeah, and ring. So I'm just asking, like, you know, like, where are we at on the rings?
For a friend, you know.
Just for a friend. So you were very, very on me about the rings.
Yeah.
And, I went to go look for a ring, and I found one that I liked, and I sent you a picture of it just to calm you down.
You did. And it worked.
Oh, also, among the passive aggressive things that you were doing to push me along on ring buying was going to get your finger sized.
From two different jewelers.
Yeah. And so you were like very like aggressive. Also, you left a...
Oh, you know, I was being helpful because, you know, I mean, if you're going to go ring shopping, you need to know what size my ring
also left a jeweler pamphlet in my car.
I swear, that was one thing that was not on purpose in all of this.
All right. So I show you a picture of the ring. And you like it.
Mm-hmm.
And that pacifies you for... How long?
Well... I wasn't actually, I can't put a time frame on that. You actually ruined some of this because I'm like, okay, well, he went ring shopping with a friend of ours.
Yeah. Let's say, and just to disguise her name, we'll call her Rachel.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you went ring shopping with Rachel and I'm like, well, I know she's got good taste. I know that she's a planner.
Yeah.
She's a planner. I'm a planner. I know that she had to have been moving you along in this process. And you had even said that she had just gotten
engaged. So she was very well versed on the whole process. Like she had just did a whole ring shopping thing with her and her fiance.
Yeah. What got me is I am a little bit picky about jewelry.
Yeah.
I don't like yellow gold. I didn't want a diamond centerpiece.
Yeah.
Did I have another parameter? I think that was pretty much it.
And by the way,
and I didn't want you spending a ton of money.
Didn't want to spend a ton of money. And all of that, as it got more and more desperate about the ring, like as if like you were just trying to hit every button to like, what button do I hit on this idiot to make a ring fall out? And so like, at some point, you were like, hey, listen, remember I told you about the diamond and the yellow gold? Don't worry about it. Yeah. Whatever. Just give me a ring. Literally any ring.
Just
whatever you want.
Go to like the little grocery store quarter machines.
Yeah.
You know, those little plastic rings, you know. So
I show you the thing. You are placated for a little bit.
Until you ruined it.
How'd I ruin it?
You sent me into panic mode because you said, hey, you know that photo I shown you, the setting for it?
Yeah.
They sold it out from under me.
Motherfuckers.
Those motherfuckers.
Ugh.
So I'm not going to be able to get it until Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And then my panic mode set in. I'm like, fuck, he's going to have to just find another ring if we're going to do this on an appropriate timeline. So I went crazy ring hunting.
So meanwhile, also we should note that once we had determined, like I had gone ring shopping, like we were moving forward, that we set a nice romantic weekend in Seattle. Got a nice hotel, booked tickets.
And we totally knew that was like going to be proposal weekend.
Yeah.
Like there's no hiding that.
No, yeah. It was well known between the two of us. And meanwhile, I am telling you, I am explaining to you how they sold out this setting from out from under me.
Yeah. And so I went crazy, Etsy ring shopping crazy, yeah, and started sending you stuff and like, oh, this looks good. This blah, 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 blah. And then eventually you say, hey, guess what? They're able to get the setting. And we'll have it. Actually, that's what it was Thanksgiving or the week after.
Yeah.
We got back from Seattle.
Yeah.
But womp womp, the sapphire.
Yeah.
There's a problem with that now, too. And that's going to take longer. And it just kept getting more and more complicated to the point to where you were making up things about.
Whoa. Making
up. Okay.
I was telling you the truth. I was explaining to you a very complicated situation. As far as you knew.
It was cruel.
Oh, they were all lies. They were all lies. It was me all along, Ashley. All of you bought it. Even my immediate family bought it. It was the performance of a lifetime.
Because you were the worst planner and it was so viable.
Yeah.
I mean, don't get me wrong. I love you, but
so you suck. I lied to you. I said all of that was malarkey. I bought the diamond. I bought the ring as I wanted it with the sapphire like a week after I saw it. I really liked it. It's the one that we wound up getting, obviously. There's a million things I like about it, and it was great. And I already showed it to you. You had given it the approval. So I was like, awesome, awesome, awesome. Because that's the other thing that, for me, I was very, very weird about was like, what if I get you a ring that you don't like? Like, yeah, you're forced to wear this like forever? You know, that's pretty dumb. I don't know why we do that in society. So I secretly have the ring. We go on the romantic weekend. And what are your best guesses as we go up there on what's going to happen? Because I've lied to you and told you that they will definitely not have it by the time that.
Well, you were lying to me the day of.
Yeah.
Where you were telling me that you just kept adding to the lies. Like you were getting off on
so
it at
lies.
This point,
yeah.
To where like, oh, I was going to get you one of those like comically huge ring pops, the novelty ring.
I was lying to you about things I would do if like that, like I was going to do instead of having the actual ring for you.
Yeah.
I was telling you about failed plans that were backup plans to the failed ring situation.
It just kept getting more and more complicated. Yeah. Which,
you bought all of it.
I bought all of it. And even like, I got a manicure before I went. And my nail lady, I'm telling her all this. And she's like, are you sure? I'm like, no, he's a total fuck up. There's no way he's going to have this ring. But yeah. So the day of, I had no idea. The only thing that I know about you is that you're an attention whore and that you were going to do it in public. That was one thing I could bet on.
Yeah.
But I had no idea like what the ring thing was going to be. And I just kind of shut that out of my mind and was like, well, you know, There's probably not going to be a ring. He's probably just going to do something silly or mushy in public, and that'll be that.
Yeah. Padres J in the chat room says that this is the important part of the proposal. I love you. You love me. Now wear this piece of crap jewelry or you will emotionally hurt me.
Yep.
That's what we do.
Yeah. That's a lot of sense. Barney song, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, so I had no clue.
But you had no idea. It was going to be
an actual ring of any sort.
That I was going to do a ring pop or something like that. Like, what did you think?
I just thought you would do something goofy and mushy because you're more of a romantic than I am. So I thought that you're just going to do something nice and sweet in front of a bunch of people.
Well, yeah. I mean, I guess I do like... I'm a fan of sentimentality.
Mm-hmm.
And I did want it to be special. Because as much as you're not a romantic person, you are not without an appreciation for effort.
No, totally.
You know, like, so I think effort was going to be a big part of it. So we're there. We're in Seattle. We decided we were going to have a very us kind of day. We woke up. We got brunch.
A bug was in my brunch.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Just to get things off on a great step.
I mean, it was really good brunch up until the bug part.
They had made a special vegan dish for you.
Yeah.
Because they didn't have anything on the menu. And it was very salad heavy. And you
but it was really,
really liked
good.
It. Yeah. Like, yeah. You were really a fan of it. And the next thing you know, it's like, oh, by the way, crawling bug. Like, not a dead bug. Not a bug that
like,
you've seen before.
Like one of those green beetles that are like maybe between a quarter and a half inch.
Yeah. Oh, no, definitely. It was gross. Yeah. It was crawly. It was like a real living thing.
They come up, they replace the salad, and because they knew I had ordered vegan, they're like, oh, don't worry, we found him a nice little home out back.
Yeah. Probably punched him.
They probably did.
Threw him in the air and punched him. So we have a nice thing. We're going. We're all around Pike Place. We're just having drinks and we're
pickles.
And we're discussing our relationship. We're kind of chronologically going through all these events that we had been through together. And then we go out. And if you are familiar with the Pike Place area, the Pike Place Market, rather, it is on, I guess, I think it would be the north side of the market, the one opposite from where the pig statue is. It's on the opposite end of the market from that.
And it has like the little totem poles and stuff.
And it's a little public park where there's totem poles. And that was where I knew were like the best views in that area. And so this is where you misjudged me, is that I am indeed an attention whore. And of course we were going to be doing this for a lot of people, but I did not care to do it for anybody around. Like, I would have proposed to you if there was nobody in that park or if there were the smattering of people that were there.
Yeah.
The people that I was performing for were the people that I knew that would be looking at this shit on the internet.
Yep.
And for that, I needed good lighting and a good background.
You know, I actually briefly thought, well, I thought that because you did not pack the travel video camera that we had, that you actually weren't going to wind up recording it, or you were going to have, you know, the Duronclon
secretly
record somewhere.
Yeah.
You totally had me fooled on that bit. So we walked down to the waterfront.
Yeah.
And
which isn't really a waterfront. It's more just like an overhang to a freeway. But it looks very nice.
I'm taking pictures of the pretty water at sunset, and you're all like, let's get a picture. And I turn around to take a selfie, and you're like, no, with my camera. And you walk up to fucking random vape bro.
There's a bro, and he's vaping.
He's vaping. He's vaping it up.
Describe to your family what vaping is.
It's like smoking, but not.
Yeah. They're your family. I mean, you describe what a vape. Who are these vape bros? You must describe for me. I am Russian Brian.
I don't know how. They smoke and they high. They high. They high, bro. Hi.
So it's water vapor.
Yeah.
They have these little vape pens, and it's electric, and they heat the water.
You said that much better than me.
The water vapor and blow it up. And yeah. Sometimes
they're getting high.
Sometimes it's just flavored stuff, and sometimes it's cannabis oil, which is legal in the state of Washington.
Which was all over Seattle that day.
Oh yeah, that was the other fun part about it, was that the Raiders were playing the Seahawks that Sunday, and they had legalized pot. So basically, downtown Seattle just fucking smelled so much like pot. And it was a bunch of people running around in Raiders jackets. So we might as well have not left the house.
Yeah.
Like, we might as well have not left Oakland. Like, all Oakland does is smell like pot and have people with Raiders jackets. And we just brought it all with us to Seattle.
So here's this random vape bro just getting high or whatever he's doing. And I'm like, no, let's just do a fucking selfie and not bother this poor vape man.
Yeah.
And he was totally down for it. He was down for it. I was super pissed. In that moment that you were walking up to strangers to take a picture. And I'm like, this is the most touristy fucking thing that you could be doing right now. Why can't we just take a selfie? And you can see in the video clip, I'm just irritated.
Yeah, you are not having a good time. Also, you don't know that we are taking video.
Yeah.
Because I had just given it to him and I turned it on video and I said, just leave this on. Beep.
Yeah.
And so that's where the video, you can see the video at youtube.com/JustinRobertYoung. That's where I have it up. But I went down on one knee and I screwed up where the box opened, and then the ring almost fell out and onto the highway. And
that would have been a bad day.
That would have been a bad day. And then you saw the ring.
And then
what was in your mind when you saw the ring? What was your first thought?
My first thought was, because I covered my face.
Yeah.
I was shocked that you had your shit together. And that sounds so bad, doesn't it?
I know. I know.
Well, that's why at the end of the video, I called you an asshole. Yes. Because it had revealed
that I had lied to you.
You had lied to me all this time.
Carl wants to know how close you were to physically harming me.
I mean, I couldn't hurt him when I got that blang on my finger.
Blang!
I might actually, like, kill him with the thing. It's as big as my finger.
So did you initially, like, did you think it was a fake ring first? Or, like when did you know that it was a real ring?
I knew it was a real ring right away. Because you had a box that had a light that shone on it.
Yeah, I'll tell you, a big shout out to Robbins Brothers. Robbins Brothers, the engagement ring store, where I bought it in Dallas, Texas. Although they have locations all over the United States.
And we ran into one on the way back from our brunch on Sunday.
Yeah, in Seattle.
Yeah.
So all their boxes are standard with a little LED light at the top that, like, shines down on the ring that makes it look really cool. And you can see it in the video. You can see the light, just the little LED light on there.
But yeah, no, I was really excited. And I did the girl and I yelled. So yeah, you can totally watch the video. I was really surprised, though.
Did you come off as girlier than you thought you were going to in the video?
Yes. I was so disappointed in myself. No, it was fine. I was just surprised that you were able to get the ring. And I actually, I didn't necessarily realize that you were lying all that time in that immediate moment.
Yeah.
But I thought it's like, oh, he was actually able to get it earlier than he thought he was going to. So if that had not been clarified, I would have thought that you were.
And then I told you later.
And then you told me later.
How much I've been building a house of lies.
How you're destroying this marriage before it starts.
Yeah. Pretty much it.
Looking forward to the divorce. It's going to be great.
So that's the engagement story. Now we will move on to some of the horsing off that we're going to do on this here show. Ashley, I got a box with a ring in it for you. You got two boxes delivered here.
There's something that when I realized... By the
way, Chimera is pointing out that right now, I don't know whether or not we'll be able to work out this referral code for Robbins Brothers, but if we do, Vape Bro will get you 10% off your ring.
Oh my goodness. Well, since we're getting married.
Yeah.
I decided that I got to be careful in moving forward, marrying the guy with the snot all over his mustache right now. Because what if we're related?
Yeah.
Like,
I don't know.
I don't want to be fucking my cousin. And then like, how many cousins is too few cousins between?
For
like,
the these record, are things the, you need that, to think about. That train has left the station.
So, I've bought us DNA testing.
Yeah.
So we can find out if we're related or not.
Yes.
And find out perhaps what Justin's real ethnicity is.
Yeah. And we don't know. We don't know what it is, but we will find it out. So we're gonna do this, and then we'll let you guys know. It's an ancestry.com.
Are you gonna spit kit. In it in here?
No, we don't need to spit on
the. Oh. Okay.
Did you want us to spit on
it? Yeah. Thing?
Well, then you get it ready.
Well, yeah, you just open it.
Go. Show me what to do. This is an audio show, so let's.
I know. Keep it moving. So you open it up, right. And then you have this tube, right?
All
right. And then you've got to spit to the black line. So you spit through this top here. Oh my God,
that's a lot of spit.
Apparently, it's less than a fourth a teaspoon. According, wait, let me make sure. Do we have the right one?
Wait, do you teaspoon out your spit?
You just spit it in here to that line. Yeah, I got the right one.
All
right,
and then you just so here, you gotta, I'm spitting here.
Mm-hmm. You just gotta spit, just to the line though. Mm-mm-mm. Spit for me, sweetie. Yeah, girl.
So wait, hold on. Is there a thing on top? I don't think. Hmm? My spit is too frothy.
Yeah, my spit's pretty frothy too. Look at that. You just maybe tap it down, you know. You know how you do that?
Oh, wait, here we go. Now we're making progress. Mm-hmm. Oh, now we're spitting with gas.
God, that sounds disgusting.
That's what she said.
So I'm really looking forward to getting.
All right, here we go. Here we go. We got it. I got you spit do? Up to here. All
right, so then what you do is all you right. take that funnel off.
Okay.
And then you have to screw that top on. All the way. And it should release the fluids into the bottom. And then once it's on, you gotta shake it for like 15 shake seconds.
Like a Polaroid and then
we'll
put picture. It
in the mail and we'll find out what your true ethnicity is.
There we go. All right. So I'm shaking up my spit.
How do you feel as someone that's been marketed as ethnically ambiguous?
I am ethically ambiguous. But number one, understand, like, I know what my ethnicity is. I keep it secret from the world so I can make racist jokes about more ethnicities than my actual ethnicity.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's the best part about it. Do I have to put it in this biohazard bag?
Yep. Did you shake it for like 15 seconds?
Yeah.
Yep. All right. Biohazard bag. And then we'll pop it in the mail. So it'll be good. Man, my spit is way too frothy for this. This might take longer for me.
All right, there we go. I am now sealing it in the box.
I'm putting it in here
in the return box that has been provided to us by Ancestry.com.
Boom, boom, boom. I think the turnaround time for this is about 8 to 12 weeks. I don't remember. But hopefully we'll know early in the new year.
Yes. Well, there we go. I have a first-class box that's going to Ancestry.com, and we are going to have a hell of a good time finding out just what ethnic or animal lineage is responsible for my mook ass. All right.
Did we have? I think we had one email, but I guess we can save that for next week. But. If you guys want to join the conversation, you can email justinrobertyoung@gmail.com or healthyaddict@gmail.com and put Jurymore in the title. And we will incorporate perhaps your letters into the show.
Yeah, I don't know. Like all the other shows that we've been doing, we've been getting really, really great email. We assume that we'll probably get really good email for this. So I think what we're looking for, people who have got married, who want to share their experiences about getting married, people who are thinking about getting married, relationship questions, we'll take it all. You want to know what? You tell us, folks. What do you guys want to talk about? And we will do our best to do it while Ashley continues to try and fill this spit tube.
I don't have a lot of spit.
You're the one who wanted to do this on air. You're already there.
No, I'm almost there. I need another milliliter. I don't know math. Something else that I'll add to. We don't yet have it up, but we do have the URL jurymore.com. So we will have a RSS feed soon, but once jurymore.com is launched, this episode will be there as well. So.
Yeah, you'll be able to get it.
Yeah.
It'll be a thing. I swear to God. It'll be amazing. Well, until next time, my name is Jury.
I'm Moore. Ashley? Ashley Moore?
Moore Ashley?
Moore Ashley.
And
keep it real.
Keep marrying it up.
Get married. Go team.
Get married. Get money.
Get album art and music, honey.
Yeah. Let us know if you have something. Oh, yeah, by the way, yeah, we're going to get album art and music. I mean, music probably is more pressing. Anyway, all right, guys. Bye.
Thanks. See you guys next week.